الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. بنشكر قسم التفعيليات ونشكر الجهة المنظمة وجمعية المصرية لعلم التفعيليات، وبنبارك التعاون بين الجمعية وبين قسم التفعيليات في كلية طب طنطا إن شاء الله، ونرجو أن يكون ده في معظم كليات الطب إن شاء الله في المستقبل. الحقيقة النهاردة يعني هنتكلم عن طوب بسيط ومهم في ان هو بين الكورليشنز بين البارازيتيك انفكشنز اند بكتيريال انفكشن. هذه ستادي عملناها في طنطا هنا مع الاماكن المحيطه بها، واخترنا البيشنتس who are attending the gastrointestinal departments and the medical departments who are suffering from gastrointestinal symptoms, for example epigastric pain, vomiting, heartburn and flatulence. والحقيقة كان بين اخذنا حوالي 206 مريض، والـ age was ranged between 15 years old up to 60 years. It was 76 males with mean age 33.2 and about 130 females with mean age. So it means that females are more prevalent for infection than males. All patients were submitted to full clinical examination, and the stool examination was performed to detect Helicobacter pylori antigen and other intestinal parasites. Why we use the stool analysis for Helicobacter? Because the test for Helicobacter in the stool is very easy, reliable, and cheap than the sensitivity are very high. The results showed that 69.4% of the patients were positive for Helicobacter pylori antigen. It means the prevalence is very high. Among the developed countries, the incidence is very low than this number. The prevalence among males and females was the same, as you see, about 70% in both. The prevalence among different age groups also was not significantly different, but somehow some high among age groups 15 to 25, and also in the age group 45 up to 60 years old. This could be due to the use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs in these ages. We have found that about 72 patients out of 140, and about 50%, were associated with co-infection with Entamoeba histolytica, mainly or Giardia lamblia. Epigastric pain and heartburn were representing about 90% of symptoms in patients with positive Helicobacter pylori antigen. This means that are we able to depend on the symptoms to treat Helicobacter pylori, or we should test it before treatment? Also, what is it? How to? I don't know why it is up. As you know, Helicobacter pylori are spiral gram negative and urease producing bacteria that can be found in the mucus and coating the gastric mucosa or between the mucus layer and the gastric epithelium. The prevalence of Helicobacter pylori varies among different countries and is significantly higher in developing than in industrialized countries. Also, the infection is most commonly acquired in childhood, and the results in a chronic, resulting in a chronic active gastritis. That is usually a long life without specific treatment. يعني if the child is getting infection with Helicobacter and not treated, he can suffer from gastritis maybe forever if it is not treated. In addition to causing chronic gastritis and peptic ulcers, the infection Helicobacter has been associated with the development of gastric adenocarcinoma and the gastric mucus-associated lymphoid tissue, linear mold, or lymphoma. This is very important. The International Agency for Research on Cancer classified Helicobacter as a group 1 carcinogen and a definite cause of gastric cancer in humans. This is why I would press on this point, because why we should research for Helicobacter, especially in childhood. This study was conducted to highlight the importance of Helicobacter pylori infection among patients with different GIT symptoms and among different age groups. Moreover, our study has explored the prevalence of Helicobacter pylori infection in particular area in Egypt, in Nile Delta, especially Tanta or the center of Delta. We have collected the patient and divided them into three groups. The group one from 15 years old to less than 25 years, and then from 25 to less than 45, and the group three from 44 years old over until 60 or over. The mean age was about 33.2, and 130 females with mean age 32.8, and the study was approved by the Research Committee Faculty of Medicine of Al-Azhar. All the patients were submitted to full clinical examination. After obtaining a full history sheet from each one, the patients were asked specifically for the presence of heartburn, epigastric pain, and nausea or vomiting, flatulence, and the bowel movement. The presence of black stool and any other associated diseases also were included. The stool sample of each patient was examined for detection of Helicobacter pylori antigen by rapid test, which is an immunochromatographic assay with 98% specificity and 95% sensitivity. This is why we have chosen this test for this study. Also, each sample was thoroughly examined for the intestinal parasites by using concentration method. The stool smears, so. We have got this is the kit for detect the Helicobacter antigen in the stool. This one, it means positive. If the control positive and the test is positive. While it is negative when the control is positive, while the test is negative. This one, if it is test is positive and the control negative, it means it is invalid test. This table also, it gives us an idea about the rate of infection among the different groups. Here, the age group from 15 to 25, this is the number, and this is the positive cases, this is the percentage. About 70% among this group. While in group two, from 25 to 45 ages, the percent was 67%. In group three, the over 45, this is a little bit high, 73.7. This is why it could be contributed to the use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs in this age. This table summarizes the symptoms of the patient with Helicobacter pylori infection. Epigastric pain represents about 91% of the symptoms. while the heartburn represents about 87%, and then flatulence about 75%, then the nausea and vomiting, loose motions, and the melena, which is the least number of symptoms. This is the one representing the association between the parasitic infections and the bacterial infections. The patient was positive for Entamoeba histolytica was 130. So this is about 50% of the patients were positive for Entamoeba histolytica cyst. While Ascaris representing about 5%, and Entrobius vermicularis 3.5%, or the Giardia number here is the least. This number could be high if we could use the chromatographic test for the Lambia. In conclusion, this study was conducted on patients attending the medical outpatient clinic, and the outcome results showed that prevalence of Helicobacter pylori infection among the population was high, around 70%, which is very high. The prevalence was more or less the same among males as well as among females. There was no significant difference of infection among the different age groups. It means all groups can be infected, no immune about the Helicobacter pylori infection. A recommendation: more epidemiological studies are needed to cover other Egyptian districts with special attention to socioeconomic status, other associated organisms, other associated diseases, environmental factors, exploration, and a genetic factor. Eradication of the infection is important, especially in childhood, because, as we mentioned before, because it is a carcinogen bacteria and it can cause chronic active gastritis forever. So more research has to be done in pharmacology to get a drug safe, easily to be taken, and more efficient against this organism. Besides, the other co-parasites and or microorganisms, if present, must be diagnosed and treated as well. More studies needed to explore the behavior, etiology, and host-parasite relationship of the organism. And also, this study opens the door to correlation between the bacterial infections and parasitic infections affecting the same organ or the same system. Thank you very much.